Good afternoon, everyone here. Well, this is what I am, Archana Sardana. I'm into bee stamping. That you've seen what all I do. Well, to start with, this is just my life history, what I'm going to talk about, because when I was a child, I used to hate adventure. So from hating adventure to, you know, becoming a part of that takes lots. So I have been brought up in a place called Jammu. You know, it's a very small town, and I'm the youngest sibling among four of us. Being the youngest, I always love that pampering and, you know, attention from all, everybody who ever used to come. My family is a very traditional family. The ladies of our house were not, they never used to go out and work. And when I was a child, even I was not allowed to venture out alone. Somebody from the family was always with me whenever I used to go out. So my life drastically changed after I got married. I got married to a naval submariner officer in the Navy. And somehow that I was destined to be whatever I am today. He was he used to love adventure. He was an adventure enthusiast. So slowly and slowly, somehow, my husband has been a part of, you know, whatever I am today. He was always there at the back. When I got married, we went to Visakhapatnam. I mean, coming from a very protective family to an atmosphere where you had nobody around. I mean, he used to go at work, I used to be alone, doing nothing. So that was a drastic change in my life. And it was very difficult to adapt all those things. But somehow, they say it has to be within you. You know, whatever situations you face, whatever you do, until and unless you accept it, you cannot be a part of it. So then I accepted, and after a few days of my marriage, there was one walkathon, and for a change, I wanted to take a part. So I told my husband, I said, I want to be a part of it, and you know, walking for, say, 50 kilometers was not a joke for me, as it is during, when I was a child, I had not even walked a kilometer. Used to be always cars, go drivers and all those things. So to accept that for him also was a difficult thing. So he said, okay, fine, just let's take a try. So to my, you know, surprise and to his surprise also, I was able to walk 50 kilometers, though I had blisters in my feet, but somehow I did that. And to his surprise, it was like, okay, fine, if she is willingly doing something, why not, you know, give a try. So after that, we went to Darjeeling for a honeymoon. He was into adventure. He did not take me anywhere. He took me to Darjeeling, where we enrolled in a 15-day adventure course. And there, getting up in the morning, you know, at 5, I was like, no, I don't want to do it. And every day I was cribbing, basically. So it was like, okay. So one day I was thinking, I was sitting and I just thought, I said, this is just a small thing. And if I give it, I mean, if I give up now, then it becomes very easy. Giving up is very easy. Everybody knows that. But to continue with the things which are difficult takes time as well as effort. And it is difficult. So I said, okay, fine, let me give a try. And some ideas, some things were coming into my mind. I said, is it that I can give up? Or is it so difficult that I cannot do it? Or what? So I said, let me give 2 days, and if again that is not possible, I'll just give up. But 2 days, I gave in my best, I mean 100%. And from that day, I mean 2 days, I was back and I started enjoying, and thereafter I've never looked back. So whatever came up after that, it was like, no, I have to do it. And then that thing happened. I got prizes. I did very good again in adventure. And we came back. Then it was, what was next was adventure course, basic adventure course. This was adventure, that was basic mountaineering course that I did in Uttarkashi, which was again very difficult. But then that was the... It is so difficult that, you know, bearing a child, I mean, during your pregnancies, whatever you go, is much more easy than doing these courses. But again, I came back with A grading. I was able to do it. It was all in my mind. So after that it was advanced. Again I did it. Everything went on very well. And in 2002, I couldn't do anything because I had two kids at time. And somehow in between I was again into adventure, which I couldn't leave. And in 2006, I was not well. I had an attack of backache. I mean, I was bedridden for 4 months because I have a problem that is compression in my back. So I was admitted in the hospital and the doctor came to me. I was taking Ayurvedic treatment and the doctor came to me and he's like, what next? What do you want to next? That time we were interacting more with the skydivers of the Navy. And that thing was somewhere in my mind as well as my husband's mind that I have to go and get into skydiving. So my doctor is like, what do you want to do? I said, I want to go for skydiving. This guy is like, you can't even drive a car. How are you going to go for skydiving? And that was in my mind. I said, no, whatever comes up, I have to go. 4 months bedridden. I got up, hired an instructor, came back to shape. And went to US to do my skydiving. And that time I came back with 51 jumps and that was B license. In skydiving you get A license, 25 jumps, B 51, C is like 200 and after that D. So I came back and the doctor was so surprised because your skydiving involves your back, your landing, it's pretty, as far as you don't know your job, it's pretty difficult and risky. But if you know what to do, then it becomes easy. I mean, the only thing is, yeah, you have to take your own responsibility. Nobody's going to come and help you in that. So I came back and then it was like, okay. And again I went. Second time I did 60 jumps. And third time when I had to go, I had this thing in mind that I have to do a flag jump. Flag jump was like Indian flag jumps, which nobody had done. And when I went to US, I realized one thing, the people of US really don't have that kind of respect for India. You know, they think Indians are very different. They are not into adventure and a lot of other things which maybe the Indians have projected in skydiving, especially in skydiving I'm talking about. So then I was like, no, the image has to be changed somehow. So I went, I had done then 130 jumps. So I needed 70 more jumps to do my flag jump basically. So that was the time I did my 170 jumps and after that 201st jump was a flag jump. And when I did that flag jump, the people of US, trust me, the way they were looking at India, I mean Indian flag jump, in Indian this flag in air looks beautiful, you must have seen here. It was like, and you know, after that, they had that kind of respect for me. Everything, you know, changes. Though they call me a crazy girl because none of the US people would do after 200 jumps. Nobody gets into flag jumps and base jumping. Okay, that was over. And then I came back and it was like, I get bored very easily. That's the problem I have, you know. So now what next? Not even me. My husband is the same kind, you know. Okay, fine. What next? So I'm like, now what next? So then it came base jumping. Now base jumping in the whole world, you have around 250 total base jumps. And you keep losing base jumps every year because it is the most riskiest sport where you can, you know, get into. Because once you jump, it takes 5 seconds to land. It is to land. And if you fall, something happens to your parachute, it takes 2 seconds to fall like a stone. So what is the basic, you know, difference between base jumping and skydiving? Well, skydiving, you jump from the aeroplane where you have two parachutes. If something happens to one, you can always cut away and open the other one, that is a reserve one. But in base jumping, you have only one parachute and the reaction time is very, very limited. So I went to, again, Salt Lake City to do my course and there I did. And initially, yes, I was scared. You're always scared doing all these things till the time you've learned it. So I did from a bridge and I did 25 jumps there. Thereafter, I came back and every year I had been going to Malaysia. Again in Malaysia, I went for my base jump. And again, whenever you do these things, some risk is always involved, and you can always expect, accidents happening. I went there, and then I was jumping again, and all of a sudden my parachute got stuck in a tree, and I just, when you fly a parachute, it's the speed is very high. So it got stuck in the tree, and I came with the full force, and I got injured like my leg basically. And that was my first jump that year. So after that, you are injured, you cannot jump anymore. And that there's a festival which is for 4 days. So this was 1 day. And in base jumping, they say you never go alone. Why? Because if you get injured also, or if you die, whatever, somebody has to be there to get your body, or you. So then I went, and that time I was alone, but luckily I had some friends, so I went to them, stayed with them. But I was still injured, and it was the 4th day. I had this thing in mind that if I go like this, then I will carry those, things with me, and I'll get that, whenever I jump next time, that thing is going to reflect in my jump. So I said, no, I can't go like that. 4th day I went, I was still not able to walk, but I made a jump and then came back. I made only 2 jumps in that 4 days. One accident and one was to come back to my jumping. So that was the experience I had, and after that, again, I'm just telling you about the incident, because what they made me after that, I'll share it after I tell you what happened. Again, I went to Arizona and I was doing some jumps. I jumped and I was like, okay, normal jump, nothing happened. And all of a sudden I'm saying, I'm coming down really fast, why? I looked up and my parachute was not open. I was like, shit, I mean, you can't just do anything. And then I was looking down, and the land comes to you very fast. So I'm like, now what? I said, okay, fine, no problems. I just did my cutaway. And it was around 700 feet when my parachute opened. For me, it was normal because I was a base jumper. So 700 is quite a height for me, so not a problem. But the people around, they were scared. They thought I'm dead. I mean, nobody can live. It was like that. So they came, they hugged me. Why I told you all this is because it's only in your mind. You have to play with your mind with all these things. That gives you more of courage. See, everybody gets opportunities like I got, right? My husband gave me a lot of opportunities. But if I had that thing in me, that's why I was able to avail. Somebody gives you an opportunity, you go. You're not able to do it. You'll come back after that. Nobody's going to, offer you anything. But once you are able to do it, that means there is something in you which you can do it. Right? Otherwise, you'll not be able to do it. Anybody can take you like a horse to a well to drink water, but can't force, right? So everybody can send you, but it is in you. You have to do it. Some people have their fixed minds. If you have fixed minds, if I had fixed mind, like a very, adamant, I care, I don't want to do it, I will not do it, or I can't do it, I wouldn't have been able to do it. Right? It's not that I don't face problems or I'm not scared. It is that I am scared at times. Things do go wrong. But after becoming whatever I am today, I think I've become a very strong person. I can handle anything. I can be like, I can do anything. It's only in mind. It's just a mind game which you have to, play with your mind. Yeah? So there's always this one saying, which is from Mark Twain, that 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed with the things you did do than the things you did not do. So throw away your bowlines, sail away from your safe harbor, let the winds catch the sails, explore, dream, discover. Now I have a scuba diving academy, so I can't teach skydiving here in India. It's very, very restricted. As well as base jumping. You have to be 18 to do, skydiving, base jumping. But I have opened a scuba diving academy where I teach all the kids how to scuba dive. Basically, what you get the exposure in sea, we give it in the pool. And now I've just come back from Shimla. We have been doing the course for the last 15 days. And whole school in the in that Shimla, which is a high altitude thing, all the kids are scuba divers at the moment. And now I'm taking them to Bali as well. So this is what I can give. After learning something, I can give back is at least some exposure to adventure, which nobody can give. You have to go to the sea and, you know, do all those things. So now my basically what she said, your bread and butter is Scuba Diving Academy, because I cannot do anything except from adventure. So yeah, so anybody anytime welcome to, you know, learn scuba any day, anytime. Thank you so much.